Okay, today we're going to talk about high and low pressure and how it's associated with weather and climate. We'll also tell you why we get high pressure and low pressure. Okay, so over here on the whiteboard, I wanted to talk about specifically high pressure. You know, what is it? So let's start with the basics again with just air molecules. So at the surface of the Earth, air is more dense. As you go up in elevation or in altitude, it is less dense. That's a general rule that's always the case. Okay, so I'll show this with some air molecules all scrunched together here, and then air molecules more spaced out. Okay, so from day to day, from hour to hour, from place to place, air pressure does change. The molecule intensity or density does vary throughout the day. So, what could cause it? Well, in general, I want us to think about air sinking. Okay, so we're associating with high pressure, more pressure, higher pressure. I want us to think about sinking air. So if these molecules were to sink, okay, and start to create more air molecules here, then we would have higher pressure or high pressure. It's really that simple. So let's take a look at several ways that you can have air molecules sink. Well, number one, you could have simply cold air. So for example, in the Arctic or the Antarctic, maybe in the continental areas of the United States and Canada, in the continental areas of Europe and Russia, it's very cold there in the wintertime. Land cools off quickly, particularly near the winter solstice and into early spring. Air is simply going to sink. We call that thermally induced. Whether it's heat driven or lack of heat, it is thermally induced. Another way that air can sink is on the leeward of a mountain. Now, the leeward of the mountain is the back side of the mountain. In the case here in Northern California, we have the Sierra Nevadas. And so I drew the Sierra Nevadas. It goes up to about, you know, 10,000, 14,000 feet in the south. And so as air is forced up, particularly during a storm event, okay, during our winter time, air is going to be forced up, but it's also going to be forced back down. Okay, so it is going to be sinking. So let me put a little icon here. The number one thing we want to remember with a high pressure is air is sinking, and here's one way they can do it. Now let me erase this. There's another thing I want us to remember before I go on to these other reasons for air sinking, like on the leeward side, okay, and I mentioned cold air. Number one, it's sinking. Let's write that down. Sinking air. Okay, number two, it is going to turn or be deflected to the right. And I live in California, so that's in the northern hemisphere. It's going to be deflected to the right. We'll also call that clockwise. Incidentally, if you live in the southern hemisphere, it will go the opposite direction. But air will still sink no matter where you are. And then number three, and I'm going to demonstrate this here in a moment, is that it diverges, this air diverges at the surface. Okay? Now right now, let's just memorize this. Sinking air, it turns to the right or clockwise in the northern hemisphere, and it diverges at the surface. Okay? So in theory, as this air is going down the backside of the Sierra Nevadas, it is turning to the right because of the Coriolis force. Now, there's a lot of friction here, and that's going to affect things. The Coriolis force isn't very strong near the surface, and so chances are it's pretty weak as the air descends on the backside of the mountain. Okay, and then our third and final way that air can sink is what I call global convection. These are known as Hadley cells, and this is a dynamic process. In other words, it's motion driven. It is not driven by heat or lack of heat, in this case, the cold areas. All right, so let's take a look. Let's erase all this now. Okay. Best I can, it doesn't seem to want to go away. Give me a second here. I want to at least have some clear board here. So let's erase the black. Now, where would heat, as I'm erasing here, where would heat be rising in mass scale around the world? Well, we know at the equator or thereabouts, it's very hot and the sun is more directly overhead. Okay, the sun is more directly overhead, and so you're going to get a surplus of heat. So let's kind of draw this as the curvature of the Earth and the sun. Let's see, I only have blue here, so we're going to kind of change it up a little bit. There's the sun. It comes down. It's directly overhead, okay, at a 90 degree angle, let's say, and this varies between 23.5 degrees south. Okay, that's the Tropic of Capricorn, and 23.5 degrees to the north, that's the Tropic of Cancer. But for this purpose, let's just think of this as right now at the equator around the equinoxes. Okay, so let's say this is 0 degrees, and it's the equator. All right, so air is it going to sink or rise from the heat? Well, the heat, especially in the afternoon, these afternoon thunderstorms, air is going to rise, okay? And so there it is, and it'll rise, you know, thousands of feet. Now, this is a bit of a leap of faith, but that air, it's obviously it can go out to outer space, but that air is going to be allowed to move toward this direction and that direction, and these are, we call this polar, okay? Okay, it can move toward the poles, and as it is spun out by the Coriolis force in both hemispheres, and it's cooler, it will sink. This will be explained later, but this sinking air, now we're back to our number one, you know, characteristic of a high pressure, sinking air. And it is dynamically induced, it's movement. And this, as we're going to see again in a future discussion here, that this is at around 30 degrees. We're going to call that the subtropical high pressure. Okay, but this is our third reason for air sinking. And I'm going to demonstrate that now with some Cheerios. Hey there. So I wanted to show you sinking Cheerios on the United States of America. Let me show you what we're looking at here. So this is a great relief map of the United States. This is the Great Central Valley of California. Here's the Sierra Nevadas in the Great Basin region, okay? Storms typically come from the west, from the south, and from directly from the west and from the northwest. And that is one way that we can get air to rise on the front side of the Sierra Nevadas and then descend on the back side or the leeward side. Okay, that's where we're going to get sinking air. But in this case here, I'm talking about global convection belts, the Hadley cells that rise near the equator or thereabouts. It does shift, and so we call it the intertropical convergence zone. But then air comes back down, as I just diagrammed, at about 30 degrees. Now here where we live, near Sacramento, is 38 degrees north of the equator. So I'm going to demonstrate that with these Cheerios right here as sinking air molecules. So here we go. Okay, I'll put that aside. And so you can see now a hill, let me show you with my hands, a hill of high pressure. What does this do? It steers storms pretty much to the north of us. We've already had one storm that actually came into California, but most of the storms that are starting to come here in October are heading to the north into Washington State and up into Canada. Okay, and often a weather person refers to this as a ridge of high pressure. So let me show you that as a profile. And here's our profile of our ridge of high pressure as we fly on around it and see it deflecting the storms to the north of us as a ridge of high pressure. Okay, and finally, I wanted to talk about anticyclonic flow, or how high pressure diverges at the surface. In this diagram, you can see it. And finally, I want to show it with the Cheerios as I drop those air molecules represented by Cheerios, and they spread out at the surface. Okay, so we're looking at the United States again. This is the west of the United States. The third characteristic of a high pressure was that air diverges at the surface, just like the diagram. So let me show that with the sinking air molecules. And here we are in the Great Basin. Here's California. Air is sinking, sinking, sinking. And notice with the Cheerios that it is spreading out. You see that at the bottom? It's starting to get wider and wider and wider. Okay, so that's the divergence that we see in the diagram. And that does it for high pressure.